Why do Russian helicopters look so big, rough, and kind of ugly? They don't look as smooth or modern as American helicopters. They're louder, heavier, and sometimes even look old-fashioned. But there's a reason behind it, and it actually makes a lot of sense. Let's explore why Russian helicopters look this way, and why that might be a good thing. First, designed for tough environments. Russian helicopters are designed to survive in the most extreme places. They must fly in freezing snow, burning deserts, muddy jungles, and places with no airfields or support. So they are built strong, big, and simple. They don't focus much on beauty or style. They focus on working in bad conditions. For example, many Russian helicopters can take off and land almost anywhere, even on dirty roads or rough fields. Their engines are strong. Their parts are tough. They can still fly even if something breaks. American helicopters, on the other hand, are made with advanced technology and are usually used in places with strong support systems. They're smaller, more high-tech, and need more careful maintenance. So, Russian helicopters are like strong trucks. American helicopters are more like fast sports cars. Second, why is there a small fan in the cockpit? Yes, that little spinning fan inside the cockpit is real. It's not a joke. It's found in many Russian helicopters like the Mi-8, Mi-24, or Mi-28. But why is it there? Because most Russian helicopters don't have built-in air conditioning. They're designed to be simple and easy to fix. So instead of using an electric cooling system, they just put in a basic fan. It cools the pilots when flying in hot places, like deserts or tropical areas. And if the fan breaks, you just replace it. No expensive repairs. Meanwhile, American helicopters usually have complex air conditioning systems to keep pilots comfortable. They're more high-tech, but harder and more expensive to fix. This small fan shows the Russian design idea. Keep it simple. Make it work. Fix it fast. Third, are Russian helicopters really louder and more shaky? Yes, they are, and here's why. Russian helicopters often use bigger and heavier rotor blades. That gives them more power, but it also creates more noise and vibration. Also, the technology to reduce noise and shaking is not as advanced in many Russian models. They don't have the same modern noise-reducing rotor shapes or smooth systems inside. American helicopters, like the Black Hawk or Apache, are built to fly quieter and smoother. They use better materials, smarter designs, and soundproofing technology. But remember, the Russian goal isn't comfort, it's strength. Even if it's noisy and it shakes, it still flies. That's what matters. There are some modern Russian helicopters, like the Kar 52 Alligator, that are better. They use a special double rotor design that reduces shaking and flies more smoothly. But most older Russian helicopters still have the loud and bumpy feel. Last, Russian helicopters are much cheaper. This is one big reason many countries buy Russian helicopters. They cost much less to buy and much less to maintain. For example, a Mi-17 costs around $10 to $15 million. An American Black Hawk, around $25 to $30 million. Also, American helicopters often come with expensive maintenance contracts. You have to buy parts, training, and service from the US company. Russia doesn't require that. They sell you the helicopter and you fix it your way. That's cheaper for many countries. That's why Russian helicopters are popular with countries that don't have big military budgets. They're not fancy, but they're affordable, reliable, and can fly in almost any condition. So in the end, Russian helicopters look big, rough, and even ugly, but that's their strength. They are strong, simple, and built to survive. They work in places where others might fail. They don't have luxury features. They don't fly silently, but they are tough, cheap, and dependable. Ugly? Maybe. Useful? Absolutely.